One, we cannot tribalize and ethnicize everything, including reports. And I'm not saying that I agree with the Kimolelo and Alao reports. I'm just saying that for a leader of majority in the Senate to invoke ethnic persuasion and ethnic angles is a very low moment in this country. And I'm therefore asking that Senator Murkomen steps aside as leader of the majority in the Senate so that he can be free to make such statements without confusing Kenyans as to what he means when he says our people. And you know very well, me, I am not in any of those formations. I don't know Kieleweke, Tanga Tanga. But me, I will start with the people of this country. And I will not see things being done. I would rather lose everything. There's nowhere in the Bible or in the Constitution that says that I must be in the leadership of this country. I would rather lose my leadership position. I would rather not be in parliament. But I'm not going to close an eye as things which we ignore them today and tomorrow they blow up into something big like we saw in this country in 2007. When it comes to this country and the safety of our people and the long-term peace and security and the rights of Kenyans to bring up their children, in this country, we only have less than 2,000 elected leaders. In a country of 50 million, I'm happy to join the 50 million. I don't have to be part of the 2,000. But anyone thinking today you are going to Chokora Maneno, and then we ignore, tomorrow you say something else, what about if Murkomen is in government tomorrow? Don't I have a reason to be afraid? Don't those people, those Kikuyus he's talking about, have a reason to be afraid? I think it's very, very unfortunate. I'll continue calling it up. Anyone, not just Murkomen, any other leader, let us not forget Kenyans, where we've come from. We might be excited in all these yasas of who is going to be what, and we forget. Because we have that problem of having a short memory. We might forget where we have come from, and we might forget some of those nuances that people throw left and right. I don't care who's going to be president. I don't care. I want to be president. Is it life and death? No. But we cannot keep on doing things the same way and then we expect different results. That I will not allow. So please, I'm asking you, Senator Murkomen, step aside.
Sio ati mtu kama mtu moja hapa anaita Kinoti. Kabla hata hajafanya investigation, ametuma SMS kwa media. Kabla hata hajasamu mtu, ashapata aweka maswali kwa media. Tuliambiwa ati Rotich ataenda kuulizwa maswali 300. Mimi nilifikiria ni propaganda. Kukuja kuona hiyo maswali ni 300. DCI already ameshaandika maswali kupatia media kabla hata tukupatia mwenye anauliza maswali. We cannot fight corruption like that. We must fight corruption objectively. And I want to tell the DCI, we are not asking you a favor. We are not trying to say be lenient. We are not. We are trying to say follow the law, do things according to the law, let the evidence lead to the victim, the criminal, or the suspect. Don't bring to us ati unakaa chini kwako asubuhi, umekaa na wanasiasa fulani, munapanga jinsi ya kuangusha mtu fulani, alafu unaanza kutangaza kusema hakuna nilisikia ati huyo DCI. Yani DCI huyo mtu tu ni bure sana. He should be sacked by tomorrow. Kwa sababu nasikia anakaanga chini anasema hii Murkomen ameongea maneno mengi sana, hakuna makosa amefanya mali. Hebu mnitafutie watu, muende mtafute hata kauni yake, mtafute nini, mkipata na makosa mniletee. You cannot run a country like that. You cannot run a country like that. And we are raising these issues because we want to have an independent institution that is able to fight corruption. And I want to request DPP Haji. His office of DPP is the most independent office. And DPP Haji hata kwa sura yake anakaa kama mtu mwenye anaogopa ulagai na uongo. I want to tell the DPP, be very careful when you receive a file from the DCI, because this DCI is already a suspect in the manner which is doing his job. And if you do so independently, there will be a lot of respect in the office of DPP. Na mimi naomba bwana DPP usiingie siasa ya kwenda kujibizana na sisi kwa television. Punguza mambo ya kujibizana na wanasiasa. Kwa sababu juzi ulituambia ati sasa 143 ni ya kabila fulani, sijui 40 fulani ni kunatoka kabila fulani, sijui 50 this of people from Are we investigating the tribe or investigating a suspect? And that is exactly what we have as a problem. Because hasa, tutauliza maswali kwa DPP. Tumuulize, hii 143 umesema, conductors ni wangapi, drivers ni wangapi, suppliers ni wangapi, wangapi walikuwa nafanyia kazi serikali na walikuwa na madaraja gani katika serikali. We will then ask him to put it in a way scale. Maybe he is telling us bodyguards and watchmen wa kabila fulani ndio wako kwa cell kwa chief, lakini CEOs na MDs na ministers ni wa kabila fulani. If you start going that direction, one DPP, it's a direction for politicians that will never